大家好, I'm Nathan Rich, aka 火锅大王. This weekend I was invited to a closed-door Mars Summit convention down in Shenzhen. As I'd never been there before and hadn't attended a Mars Summit event yet, I accepted the invitation, a little unsure of how it would all go. I've been to many conventions before, but a lot of them are filled with sales teams trying to showcase their latest products. After a weekend of experience at the Mars Summit, I'm going to tell you what it was like. The Mars Summit is an executive technical convention that takes place in Shenzhen. Global tech leaders and prominent people from other tech-related fields gather and discuss global topics and China-specific topics. So late last week, I headed down to check it out. Touchdown in Shenzhen was nice, mostly because of the humidity and heat. It reminded me of my days in Florida. We were received by a Martian and escorted to the hotel in Shekou in the Nanshan district. After check-in and some wandering around exploring the area, the event began with dinner and drinks. There were guests from around the world, including Finland, America, UK, and China. Tech leaders and innovators, people on the forefront of the scene. Everyone introduced themselves and mentioned what they thought they would get out of the event. I let everyone know I was excited to be sent to Mars, a dream of mine since I was a kid. Afterwards, though, someone informed me that, sadly, this convention wasn't a preparation event to blast us all to Mars, but rather a technical meeting of minds. This must be why they provide us with alcohol, I told myself, to ease the depression from the news that we're all still stuck here on Earth. I won't list everything that happened, but the people were nice and it was very informative. We toured Atlas brand office spaces and I chatted with several people and made some new friends. Pasi Karppinen, a Finnish guy, swore he could make concrete intelligent. And Adrian Kaler, co-author of Learning OpenCV and general AI nerd, told us about his secretive new startup. The next day, the main event began. There were various presentations with subjects ranging from challenges of tech in India to the future of AI technologies. Louis Yang, founder of Musical.ly, which evolved into Douyin and TikTok, shared his experiences and thoughts about the future of content, alongside Jiro Ladenbrandt, chairman of Troop Network from Finland, and Olivier Dumont, an executive from Entertainment One, owners of Peppa Pig and other brands. There was also an interesting presentation by Sun Yu, CEO of FlexLink, about putting chipsets in human brains in an effort to defeat any number of human conditions like paralysis from strokes, behavioral issues, and more. Cyborgs are coming soon. We went to the headquarters of DJI, where we were greeted by Luo Zhenhua, the president of the company. We got a good introduction to their various drone models and capabilities, DJI's business model, and even a couple of drone test flights. I couldn't help but think of how far technology has come and how far we still have to go. They introduced us to a competition they were trying to get going, some kind of robot wars arena with machines shooting each other. What could go wrong? After that, drinks and dinner. The next day, we headed out to prototype some sensor-based IoT products made by M5 with support by a company called Hax. Then we all talked about the future of technology in China. As I listened to entrepreneurs describing their business models and products, I couldn't help but be inspired. It's easy to forget that people are out there starting new ventures, starting new trends, and pushing for development sometimes. No matter how big or small, all of our efforts shuffle into the larger deck, progress. You know, I've been to lots of startup companies before, and it was really encouraging to see the technical leading edge here in China. China's shifting from a dependent state to an innovative state when it comes to technologies, and it's very inspiring. Take a look at China's rank in intellectual property filings. Even when we combine European countries into one entity, China files for the most patents, it files for the most trademarks, and also the most industrial designs. These are key metrics. Note that patents are more than twice the nearest competitor. Industrial designs are 5 times the nearest competitor, and trademarks are over 9 times as much. China is growing in innovation at an unprecedented rate, which makes me feel proud to be in the center of it. While these stats say Asia leads, of course it's China that is leading Asia. The experience was better than the usual tech convention I've gone to, more casual and friendly, more down to earth and inviting. But make no mistake, hidden under the surface of conventions like these is a wide and powerful understanding. China is pushing into the innovation sphere and continues to extend its lead. Before long, it very may well be the world's new tech leader. Special thanks to Yan from the Mars Summit and all the Martians who helped the adventure along. Thanks everyone, 再见.
day of the Mars Summit. We went to a place called Hacks. We did an M5 prototyping workshop, which was pretty cool. My team made a human detector. All in all, it was a good experience. Shenzhen is pretty cool. Probably not somewhere I'd want to live necessarily, but from what I've seen. But I haven't really seen a lot of the city, so still more to check out. Thank you, Mars Summit.